What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back, and we have the world reveal trailer for Black Ops 3. I'm going to show you a slow motion version, cut up a little bit. I'm going to pause a couple things and show you, not an in-depth breakdown, because I have some really big news for you guys. I was able to go out to Treyarch Studios and play Black Ops 3 multiplayer and just soak up all the information I could about it, and they are going to let me share it with you. So there's links in the description to everything that you're going to have questions about. I mean, absolutely everything from swimming specialist, thrust jumping, you name it. So be sure to watch my channel all day because I'm going to answer every question that you guys have. But as you can see by this trailer, let's talk about this. This thing looks absolutely amazing. The graphics, it's a new graphics engine that they're using. And I'm going to pause it right there because you see the guy jumping into water and you're like, well, that's campaign, right? It's also going to be in multiplayer, and I'm going to explain exactly how that works in a swimming video for you guys, so check it out. Look at this dude. That is a specialist called the Reaper, and that is a scythe, which I will tell you more about in the other video. And then we have dragonflies from hell, and they catch you on fire, and co-op, four-player co-op, guys. Everybody asked for this. It's back. Open area levels where you could go back in over and over and over and get a different experience with the game. And if you guys want to see the full trailer, if you want to see it uncut, unedited, click the link at the top of the description of this video and you can go watch it. Share it around. It looks like a warthog. Just say it. Anyway, so it starts to get a little deeper here where it looks like I think there's going to be time travel. That looks like a Cap 40 gun. And right here where they're going down this mysterious hallway with the light at the end of the tunnel, I'm pretty sure that these dudes are going to go back in time to stop something, and you'll see why I say that here in a second. I'm going to pause it, and this looks like a Terminator sequence where he time shifts back, and then he's all like double gutted over, and then that's an old car in the background, I believe, but that's not why I really think it. Right here, that's either Hudson or Alex Mason. I'm not for sure, but that looks like zombies. That looks like the bus station, does it not? I mean, they're just trying to trip us out here, but that looks like Alex Mason or Hudson. It looks like he went back in time to have to kill this guy. So I'm wondering what they're trying to change in the timeline. If zombies is going to be included somehow in the campaign, I don't know. We don't know where Dr. Salim fits in this, but it has to be something to do with either zombies or going back in time to stop an event or both. I don't know. Here we go. The dude, like, it's just so high tech on what they're doing here. But you guys, don't worry. Don't assume anything bad. I know there's a lot of people that are making assumptions from what they see, and I'm going to explain it all to you. Do not worry. Treyarch has your best interest in mind, and you guys are going to be thoroughly happy with this game. I assure you, there's so many cool things about this game, like the specialist characters and everything like that. But this campaign looks like it's going to be a blast. Let me know if you guys want me to do a campaign walkthrough when the game actually launches in the future, and I could do that for you. And then we get a little zombie teaser here at the end. You guys enjoy that. Click the link to check out the full trailer and click all the other links because I have you guys covered today. Drop a like, be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you later.